Hi, welcome to this week's special episode of the Shtick, because this week we're celebrating Israel's 68th anniversary since its independence. And just to make everyone aware of what Israel is really all about these days, it is about innovation and the startup economy, if you want to see in that term. And to make it even more interesting, we have a young man here who is an upstart. His name is Ronen Heine.
Hi.
Hi, how are you going?
Good, how are you?
All right, I'm in a good mood today.
Yeah, well, it's great to be here. Thanks for having me.
It's fantastic to have you on the Shtick, because I want to ask you, what is your shtick?
My shtick? Well, I am currently in the startup space. I'm a lawyer by trade, but I founded a legal and accounting startups where we help other startups start up, if you like. So my shtick is former corporate lawyer at Arnold Bloch Leibler, and sort of decided I wanted to be in the startup space and work with younger people who had big ideas. So we try help those younger people to make their ideas happen.
Fantastic. And you're involved with a project called Mamilla.
Yes, Mamilla. So this is a project that I've been working on for about 8 months with a few other people. The idea was co-founded by myself, Amanda Miller, Tracie Olcha, and Jonathan Gavishon when we were over in Israel last year in mid-June on a startup program over there.
And that was put on by the ROI Community.
Yes, the ROI Community. So that's put on by the Schusterman Foundation, and basically just, you know, count my lucky blessings that I actually got to go on that program. What it did was it got together a whole bunch of people from around the world who are all Jewish in the startup space together for a week and connected them with each other and with the Israeli startup ecosystem.
And you met a guy called Dave Sharma.
Yeah, Dave, the Australian Ambassador to Israel. Quite funnily enough, it's sort of where Project Mamilla came from. It was actually a meeting with Dave in Israel. He had heard about the ROI program and wanted to meet up with myself, Tracie, Amanda and Jonathan after the program to see what it was all about. And he was just loving the innovation and startups and you know, this idea of wanting to disrupt, and he was loving his time in Israel, and we got talking, and I guess Mamilla was almost born in that meeting with Dave.
I think every politician, I think Michael Danby and David Southwick and all the people, Mark Dreyfus, have done everything they can to get politicians to go to Israel to see what's going on there in the way of innovation and startups.
Yeah.
And every one of them that I've spoken to and I've seen their interviews have been so enthusiastic that they're doubling their efforts to make that connection. And I think that the first thing Malcolm Turnbull did when he became the Prime Minister was talk about innovation, and with that speech that he did with Alan Finkel when he became the Chief Scientist.
Yeah, it's amazing. And that's where it's at. In the startup space in Australia, everyone's talking about Israel and connecting with Israel, not in a political sense anymore. It's all about technology and getting a step ahead and utilizing technology that's coming out of Israel. I mean, we I think in November last year, the Australia Israel Chamber of Commerce, together with some partners in Australia, put on a conference called the Bridge Summit. This was in Sydney at Telstra headquarters, and the CEO from Telstra gets on stage there, and he sort of gets up there and says, "I've just come back from Israel," and this guy was high on life. This is the CEO of Australia's greatest technology company getting up there and saying, you know, he's going back to Israel twice a year and making it mandatory for the rest of the board. And it's just, it's amazing.
So there's also another project you're involved with, which is called Launchpad.
Yeah, so Launchpad. Launchpad, I guess I'm a bit of a recipient of this great program. It's a program mainly run by the Australian Jewish Funders, which was put together by Debbie Dadon a few years ago. And she then hired Tracie Olcha as the CEO of the Australian Jewish Funders. And this program basically gets young Jewish people together to create innovative solutions to problems facing the Jewish community currently. I was lucky enough to go on the first launch pad, and yeah, it's an amazing, amazing program.
And back to Mamilla, there's the what is going on there is the work between the coaches and the people who've got the ideas.
Yeah.
That's what it's really all about.
Absolutely. So we have, what we're doing is we're pairing coaches who are like our mentors. So these are people who are in their, you know, late 30s, 40s to 50s who are successful entrepreneurs themselves, and pairing them up with, let's call it wannabe entrepreneurs, our game changers, young people with ideas who are Jewish. The coaches are Jewish, the game changers are Jewish, helping them with their, to get their startups going, and then connecting, taking them on a program together where they'll work on their business, develop the business model, and then taking them all over to Israel to connect with technology and startups over in Israel to try help the game changers who are entrepreneurs get a step ahead in their startups.
So it's turning theory into practice, basically.
Absolutely.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah, and it's about connecting you know, people in our community together to make a really strong community in a business sense. This is about making sure that the Australian Jewish community, you know, the young people who have ideas are leaders in business, and you know, we think startups are the main drivers for the economy going forward, if you, especially with Malcolm Turnbull's, you know, ideas boom and initiative that he launched last year. You know, we have to be innovative. We can't rely on resources in Australia. It's all about being innovative in startups and utilising technology and entrepreneurship.
That's so good. I'm looking forward to seeing and hearing more about it. It's been really great to have you on the Shtick.
Pleasure
Ronen.
Being here.
You'll be back again.
Thanks,
and,
Henry.
We're going out now and we're going to see a bit of Newt's News. After Newt's News, we'll have Eileen Fried here from Zionism Victoria talking about commemorating and celebrating Israel's trials and tribulations and anniversary.
When Israel attained independence, its people arrived back to where they started. Back home, only to summon that cycle of discovery again and help to make our world richer, stronger, safer, and healthier. I hope the people of Israel never cease from their exploration. I hope the men and women in the diaspora are always granted the freedom to join them in person and in spirit. I hope the governments of our country, all the way on the other side of the world, never leave their side. And so long as I have anything to do with it, our Victorian government never will.